My name is Peter Kachenko, and I'm the Director of Operations here at Third Sun Solar. We install residential, commercial, and industrial solar systems. So basically, we mount solar panels on roofs, we create energy, and we allow customers to create their own energy and put it back into the utility grid. Well, solar is a growing industry in Ohio, so we have anywhere from 6 to 15 installers, some being real small companies, some being real big companies. There's a lot of electricians out there, there's a lot of laborers out there who can do the installs, but there's not a lot of energy analysts who understand power usage and understand the financials to actually sell the systems. So one of our biggest challenges is not physically installing the systems, it's coming up with a package that financially works for the customer that makes them purchase the systems. So we need more educated salesmen, we need more educated energy analysts to be able to build these packages and design these systems that financially make sense. They would have to have a good understanding of math, a good understanding of energy and power and how energy and electricity works. So it's real crucial to understand power usage and what power means. So there's a lot of math involved, a lot of financial numbers involved. They're expensive systems, so we need to estimate what the systems are going to produce and come up with a payback so that it financially makes sense, and we need to be able to make a model that there's a financial payback in installing solar. One of the major responsibilities is we need to get it right. We need to make sure that we plan for production. So solar is based on a lot of variables on production, so we have to analyze how much power we think the system will produce within a year. And we have to take into account that we're going to have sunny days, we're going to have cloudy days, and we have to take an average estimate of how much power these solar systems are going to produce, and then compare that to how much energy the homeowner or business owner uses, and make sure that those equations meet each other or match each other. I enjoy seeing customers' meters spin backward, so when we fully install a system and it starts cranking out energy and their meter spins backward, so they're selling power to the utility instead of buying power. That's kind of the big thing at the end of the day that makes you smile. And I like seeing customers' utility bills. We get a lot of utility bills. They email them in and they have a $1 utility bill or a $0 utility bill. So those are the good parts. Some of the parts that aren't as interesting are sitting down crunching the numbers sometimes. There's a lot of computer time, a lot of financial, reviewing numbers, trying to make things work for customers financially. So that part could be the less exciting part of things. Accounting and science, I think, would be the two major courses. But I would definitely look into accounting, learning how to use Excel, learning how to use math programs. Kind of all those math equations that I thought I'd never use in high school, I use them pretty regularly in the industry here. Energy is complicated because it's power and it's power over time, which makes it complicated. It's not just a flat equation. So you need to have a thorough understanding of how power is created over time and what that how that equates to usage and need. Because at the end of the day, energy is dollars, and all the market's driven by money, and everybody wants to save money, or we need to come up with cheaper solutions for energy. So you need to have a good understanding of financing and how financing works with the energy market. Knowing how to build math formulas and knowing how to put numbers and packages and finances together would help a ton. So if you could do anything in the accounting world, in the personal finance world, take courses in personal finance, shadow an accountant, things like that would help. Sharpen your pencil. Be smart. Study a lot. Know your formulas. Know what you're talking about. The biggest mistake people can make is overestimating production or making your costs too cheap or too expensive. Both can be. If you analyze something being cheaper than it really is, you're putting out a false concept out there. People become disappointed and then turns them off. And on the other end, if it's too expensive, nobody will go for it. And you won't make any sales, or you won't move the industry in the direction you want it to. So my advice would be to keep a sharp pencil, try to get your numbers as tight as possible, and pay attention.